Grandpa, you liking everything?
Yeah, yeah.
Good time?
Yeah.
Great. Why don't you walk by?
Bye.
Bye.
Experience.
So what was the industry up here?
A log in of an engineer.
Thank you.
to the Atlantic shelf and the southwest. It cuts Scotland in two. The rocks which form the highlands of Scotland were laid down in warm tropical seas far to the south of the equator more than 500 million years ago. Around 400 million years ago, the continents of North America and Europe collided. And let us take a look at the history of the Loch Ness Monster and see if it provides any clues. The first recorded sighting of a mysterious creature in the loch was in 565 AD by St. Columba, a Scotlandic missionary who was teaching Christianity to the native Picts in the area. The story was probably just a parable to show the power of the Church of the Christians. Sightings of a big fish occurred in the 19th and early 20th century, but in 1933, this story suddenly exploded upon the world with a series of sightings and photographs. The most famous picture, that of a graceful neck protruding from the water, turned out to have been faked, but it will always remain the iconic image of the Loch Ness Monster. Scientists have shown that long-necked animals could not live in the cold water, owing to its temperature and the lack of an adequate food supply. A moving mistake, diving birds, and even deliberate invention. The vast majority of sightings are of a single hump, and those could be large living creatures. Sonar confirms strong contacts in the deep water, the domain of fish rather than air breathers. One suggestion is that sturgeon may have been introduced to the river system, and it is known they can live for centuries and grow to enormous proportions. The world record being 8.3 metres and over 240 years old. They must not be a big thank you.
Thank you. Connors is going to, he's going to get...
I love that.
Is that you?
Yeah,
that was Matthew right here.
This is
here.
Just, really cool.
It's going to be called Half Unsure Insular Majuscule.
Okay.
Okay, just so you, you know, don't forget. Hands on calligraphy like this. I think we're the only group in the whole of Britain that does it.
Yeah, you probably should
have. It's not only messy, it takes a lot of work to control everybody. Different ends.
Yes.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
She was Scotland's greatest king, 1314. Is this, are you with this?
Yes.
Is this for some of your tour?
No.
Yes. How many more of
you? There's seven.
We want to get them together, I'll give you a wee taste of them.
That's one here, and then...
She's coming.
Just waiting, Charles.
Religion is obviously, was obviously integral to every part of life, from welfare, health, education, and of course discipline. So heresy was not tolerated. And that is why we have this
Oh,
going back all the way to 1621, and teaching still happens here. This is still the College of Divinity. I've got psychology over here, and we've got the King James Library, which was actually founded by a donation. So King James the Sixth, he donated a little bit along with the Archbishop of Canterbury in order to make this library here. It said that, no, I think it's a fact. I don't think it's just said, it's a fact. And Mary, Queen of Scots, she visited